Welcome viewer, back to Artistry. I am Tirus Wanyoike. Now, I want to have a view again on the application of the manufactured boards. Last time we discussed many of them. We have the chipboard, we have the MDF, we have the solid wood. This is pine for your information. We have mahogany, mini strips, laminated together. We have the MDF ply. We have the veneered plywood. We have the ordinary plywood. We have the block board. This is well finished MDF. So the finishing here is different from this. So you can get MDF or chipboard in any color of finishing that of your choice. And then MDF, you can easily also shape it. I'm sure you will have desks in our reception areas that have been shaped in different shapes. The shaping could easily be done using the router machine or even hand tools that we can use. So the finishing will come in any color, in any texture or appearance that you would like to have, and different qualities as well, because nowadays we have a variety of items from Europe, from Asia, from even Africa. Depending on our budget, then we are able to get one of our choices that will fit our pockets, because that is a factor to be considered as well. Because if you have your pocket is full, then you can get the highest level, which ranges from the solid wood all the way to the veneered block board. These are among the best choices that we have here. So there is little difference between this and this, although one is a manufactured board and the other one is solid wood. So this is trying to catch up with this. So of course, this must be more expensive than this. But one advantage of veneered construction or manufactured boards is that it comes ready for use, and also you can use it in a wide area, and it is not going to warp because the construction has been well done on the inside. So the mahogany finish could also be substituted by meru oak or any other expensive wood that could have, we can have a ply on, and then it resembles the real wood. So applications of these manufactured boards, especially the veneered plywood, it is normally used for high quality joinery, and sometimes it's also used to do the back of the chairs. As you can see here, we have a very good quality chair. So this chair is made of mukango. Mukango is an indigenous type of wood that is a hardwood. It is the one that has been used to finish the, or rather to make this seat. And then the back. You can see the back here is a bit shaped. So to obtain that, we cannot shape a very big block for us to get that. So what we do, we use multiple plywoods. So on the inside, we can use this type of plywood, the ordinary plywood. And then the last ply here and back, we can use the good quality or the high grade plywood that has been veneered. But for this particular seat, we have used solid wood thin sheets. So we have made a jig for it that resembles that shape, and then we have clamped it together. So the value of this is much higher than clamping many of these and decorating it with a veneered construction. So this is a special model from our workshop. So it is a high quality hardwood mukango, and then the joints are quite well done. You can see the joints, the joinery work that has been done on it, and then we have grooved for the seat, the part that we sit on. We have grooved it on the ends, and then we glue it together. So it is a quality chair that will last for so long. Again, the concept that has been used on the stands, you can see the stand is wide, and it is not so thick, because the strength that we need is on depth that interprets here to width, and also it is placed like that. So it is different from if we would place it this way. So this way it has enough depth, so it is strong enough. So that seat is very strong, they will last for long, and so it's our model seat that we use in the workshop here. So uses of blockboard. Blockboard has various uses. Some among them are tabletops as well. You can use it for tabletops. And right next to me here is a path or a cross section of a partition. So this is a double wall partition where we have a 12 millimeter blockboard on this side. We have a 12 millimeter blockboard on the other side. We have a 50 by 50 millimeter piece of wood, a piece of timber right there. So this is a cross section. So if we would consider also the side, it has been painted black. So by the point you paint it now, nobody is able to know what is inside there. But since it's a partition, we need it to be strong. We need it also to be, this kind of construction also is soundproof, because the sound will not go beyond the two, the vacuumed surface here, or rather the space between the two boards. So it's quite a strong partition. Then there has a good paintwork done on it, black. And then the edges could be made another color, yellow. So there will be another piece of wood that will run down all the way to bottom, and tops as well. Top, side, bottom will have that kind of finish. And then the partition will be very sound. So that is the inside construction of a partition. So the partition is quite expensive, because it has two block boards, and then it has been painted, as you can see, different paintings done on it, and then finally sanded and finished. So that makes the block board partition very attractive to look on, and also there is a lot of value added on it. So that is one of the uses of blockboard. As you can see, that's a very beautiful piece of item, or rather partition. The next time you are doing your partitions, it is important to know what to use for the partition. You can use, the framework could be solid wood, and then you may have plywood. Plywood also comes in various thicknesses. You may have ordinary plywood that will be 6 millimeters. Then you could have a 6-ply. 6-ply meaning two plywoods have been glued together, but now it comes a whole sheet, 6 millimeter. So it will be more expensive than the ordinary 3 millimeter plywood. So after the framework, the carcass as we call it, then you can either put 6-ply on one or both sides. Depending on the use, you could use blockboard like we have used here. You could use MDF, but the MDF you could use also could be this rough, then you paint it. You could use MDF that is well prepared, the surface. You could use chipboard that has similar finish with the MDF. There are so many varieties of materials that you could use. And now I think we have covered most of the manufactured boards that are regularly in use in our markets. And the next time you are going to do your shopping, you are more enlightened on what material the fundi shall use, because many of us are mixed between very good furniture and also long-lasting furniture, quick furniture. We need lasting furniture, then we need furniture with very good finish, and we are not able now to tell the difference between all this. But now when you go, you'll be able now to say, I need an MDF TV unit, I need a chipboard TV unit, I need a blockboard TV unit, I need an item made of veneered plywood, and so on and so on. When you're doing your partition work, you need to know what has been used on the partition. And it's not a must that we have the two block boards together. You may have one and then the other side may be not visible or may not be the face of the partition, and then we just do away with the very nice finish on the other side. We do only a good finish on one side, then we paint it, and then we are going to have a very good presentable service. So with all this information now, you are able to make an informed choice. And the next time also you are going for your furniture, you may either choose to use the solid wood. Again, we have hardwood, we have softwood on it. So you can be able now to make an informed choice. And now we have come to the end of our program. And till next time, I am your presenter, Tirus Wanyoike. Have a nice time. Thank you.